Hello and welcome to today's broadcast of the Point University Skyhawks going up against the Truett-McConnell Bears. We're going to be getting way understarted here pretty soon as we get the final few warm-up pitches. Your starting pitcher for the Skyhawks will be Austin Tebow, number 15. The senior from Fort Walton Beach, Florida. Your Point University Skyhawks have an 8-3 record coming into tonight's game with a one-game winning streak. They are 1-2 in conference. This game will not be a conference game as these are former conference rivals but no longer in the same conference anymore, as the Skyhawks have moved into a different conference. The Truett-McConnell Bears are 7-6 coming into tonight's game. They are currently on a two-game losing streak and also 1-2 in conference. In last year's game, Truett-McConnell did defeat the Skyhawks, so the Skyhawks looking for a little bit of revenge this year. Looks like the final warm-up pitch has been thrown, and the game will be getting underway.
Leading off for the Bears, number 99, Taylor Ramsey.
The first matchup today will be Austin Tebow pitching against Caleb Ramsey, the left fielder for the Bears. Here's the first pitch. First pitch will be a called strike. Starting off with an off-speed pitch. Caleb Ramsey tried to dodge the pitch, but it curves back in for a strike. Second pitch will also be called a strike down early in this count. Austin Tebow off to a great start here in this game. Looking to put him away here. Will be fouled away. In play, possibly catchable, but out of range for the third baseman. It'll go down as a foul ball. In his previous outing, Austin Tebow pitched two innings, only gave up one hit, had one strikeout, and no earned runs. Looking to have a repeat performance of that last game. It'll remain an 0-2 count after the foul ball. Next pitch is fouled off once again. This one will not be playable. Four consecutive strikes, looking to put him away here. That pitch will be just barely fouled down at the plate. Got enough of it to stay alive. Playing defensively here. Austin Tebow is a left-handed pitcher. South side. Get another foul ball here. Ooh, not caught by the dugoutman. Caleb Ramsey looking to get some pitches out of Austin Tebow here. Steps off the rubber. First pitch will finally be called a ball here. Caleb Ramsey looking to get back into this count. Second ball. It'll be a 2-2 count. Austin Tebow can't seem to find that put-away pitch to get the first out of this game. That ball will be roped into the gap in between center field and left field. Caleb Ramsey rounding first, going to second. He'll stop there. And after five consecutive strikes, able to put the ball in play and get a double to lead off this game for the Bears. Stepping into the plate now is the designated hitter, Brody Ginter. Brody Ginter responsible for a double in his last game. Looking for that same hit today. It'll bring in the first run already for the Bears, who have a man in running in scoring position. As Caleb Ramsey currently sits on second base. First pitch is called a strike. This outside pitcher goes to the plate. Hits in between the gap of right field. The right fielder will collect it, throw it in, and the runner will stay at third. So two consecutive hits here to start off for the Bears. And they will have runners at first and third with nobody out. Tebow doing a good job of getting ahead in the count early here, but can't seem to put players away, and they're getting bats on balls.
It's not bad at number 9, Tanner Griffith.
Tanner Griffith steps in, looking to score some runs here for the Bears. Throwback. Runners will remain safe. Not a huge lead out there in first base. To the plate this time. It'll be called a ball. After facing two batters, Austin Tebow has already given up more hits than he did in his last outing. Second pitch will be called a strike. Third base coach gives a call to the Bears. All the runners and the batter will check their play call sheet. As we got another throwback here. That's a smart play by the Skyhawks to mess up their play call. Force them to change up. Here's the pitch. Grounded to the second baseman. He throws it to the shortstop. Shortstop throws it to the first. They will sacrifice the run but get the double play. So the Bears will go up 1-0. And the bases will be cleared via the double play. So it'll be a 4-6-3 putout. And it'll be two outs with nobody on. Jordan Kinty will step up to bat, take strike one. Next pitch will be called a ball. Ball two. Tebow looking to end this inning, get the Skyhawks to bats up. See if we can tie this game back up or retake the lead. That ball will be hit. A dribble up to the second baseman. Well collected. Third in the first, and that'll be the third out there for the Skyhawks, who give up one run in the inning, but just the first. And we'll be back here on the Skyhawk Sports Network.
number 6, Jalen Mazzafaro.
It'll be the Skyhawks' first turn to hit the bat. Leading off for the Skyhawks is Jalen Mazzafaro. Going to be stepping into the left-handed batter's box as he gets the first pitch from the pitcher here. Swung on and fouled back. Your pitcher for the Bears is Philip Braswell, number 25. He's a junior out of Warner Robins, Georgia. A left-handed pitcher as well. Called strike. It'll be an 0-2 count. In his previous game, Philip Braswell pitched 2 innings, gave up 1 hit, 3 walks, and 1 earned run. Here's a contact here from the Skyhawks. It'll be down in for a base hit into left field. Good start there from Mazzafaro. He'll remain on first base as it doesn't go too far into left field.
Next up to bat, your right fielder, number 1, Kenny Jackson.
Kenny Jackson stepping in. Looking to tie this game up. First pitch will be thrown to the pickoff. Will not be successful as the batter wasn't too far off first base. Certainly not much of an aggressive lead out there. Here's the pitch. Swung on. Hits Kenny Jackson for a foul ball. Kenny needs some time here as he drops the bat. Seems to be okay. Coach Tyler coming out to check on him, make sure he's all right. Pitch was very inside, forcing Kenny to get his hands inside of that pitch. Manages to foul it off the barrel of the bat, but right into him. Coach Tyler checks on him, is it okay? He's just head back to the dugout. Jackson will step back into the batter's box for another pitch. Called strike 2. O2 count here for Kenny Jackson. High pitch will be called ball 1. An early lead here for the Bears as they score 1 in the top of the first. That pitch will be swung on, dropped by the catcher. Looks like it was fouled off just barely by Kenny Jackson. Able to stay alive here with 2 strikes. Not enough for me to hear the foul tip, but both umpires called it. Swung on, dribbled up into the shortstop, makes a good play, throws it to the second, throws it to first. Good throw by the second baseman, but it will not be in time. And Kenny Jackson will exchange himself for Mazzafaro on first base.
Now batting, number 8, Slay Mink.
So with 1 out, the Skyhawks will remain at first base. Slay Mink stepping into the bat. Another pickoff move here by the Bears will be unsuccessful once again. Starts off 2 at-bats in a row with a pickoff move. Comes to the plate this time. Swung on, fouled to the left of the third baseline. An early 0-1 count here for the third baseman, Slade Mink. Left fielder back on the field after retrieving that foul ball. That ball will be fouled away back deep behind the plate. We're an 0-2 count. Lots of foul balls here early in this game. Aggressive hitting here by the Skyhawks. Definitely swinging the bat a lot. Comes to the plate. Swung on once again, fouled away. Definitely appears to be part of the Skyhawks game plan. Swing the bat. Certainly how you score runs in baseball. Kenny Jackson with a bit more of an aggressive lead up there in first, as Slade Mink fouls another one off to the left. Ball was certainly hard hit. Out of the ballpark, but foul. Four pitches to Slade Mink, and all four have been foul balls. That ball will be a ball thrown to the first base by the catcher. Will not be successful. Kenny Jackson's not too far off the base, but tried to catch him. Another pitch, swung on. This will be fouled once again. They'll remain a 1-2 count. Lots of ground balls here early in the first inning as well. That pitch will be outside, but swung on and missed by Mink, who strikes out.
Now bat at your first baseman, number 33, Zeb Bears.
Zeb Bears stepping in with two outs, trying to get the Skyhawks on the board as they trail 1-0 early in this game. First pitch inside, call ball. So Slade Mink faced about 8 or 9 pitches in that bat and swung at all but one of them. That ball will be swung into the shortstop, who does not field the ball. Kenny Jackson will remain at second base, but that'll go down as a hit for Zeb. A good swing there early in the count. Skyhawks now have runners at first and second with two outs.
Off the bat, number 13, Alex Marquand.
Alex Marquand steps up to bat, one of the hottest hitters for the Skyhawks early this season. He was responsible for a double and a home run in his last outing. Here's the pitch to him. Will be a ball high. Marquand showing off the power. He has many extra base hits so far this season. Could use one here, does the Skyhawks. That second pitch will be call the ball outside. Good hitter's count here for the Skyhawks. Two outs, looking for some late inning action. Next pitch will be in the dirt, ball three. Only one bag to place the runner here. Silas Butler waiting in the on-deck circle, itching to get a chance to swing the bat with runners in scoring position and on all bases. Next pitch will be called a strike, so it'll be a 3-1 count. Marquand looks to be taken all the way there as he put the bat down. Next pitch swung on, hit towards the second baseman, a light ball, who throws it to first and gets the final out. So the Skyhawks threaten the Bears, but will not score. And we'll catch y'all at the top of the second inning after this break. We return to the top of the second inning for the first pitch. That is called a ball. Austin Tebow back on the mound for his second inning of work. Gave up a run in his first inning. And this ball will be hit high into the air to the second baseman, who gets under it and makes the catch. Early first out here for the Skyhawks. Caleb Adair steps in for the Bears. Gets a call from the third base coach before stepping in. Checks his play sheet before getting the pitch. Shows bunt. It'll be called a strike as he pulls back. Here's the next pitch. Called a strike two. Doesn't show bunt that time, but he takes the pitch anyways for an 0-2 count. Third pitch. Call the ball. Take it all away. One, two count with one out. Next pitch. Strike three. Caleb Adair watches three consecutive pitches go by him, and that one's going to be called for strike three. As Austin Tebow gets his first strikeout.
Not bad. Number one, Ethan Roberts.
Ethan Roberts here, the center fielder for the Bears, stepping in. Shows bunt, pulls back, called strike. Off-speed pitches look really good here today for Austin Tebow. The Bears batters seem to be thinking they're going to be outside, and they pull back in. Second pitch, called strike. Austin Tebow quite aggressive, throwing a lot of strikes here, especially early in the count. Next pitch, swung on, hits the third baseman. The shortstop is able to collect it, throws it to first, but well into the left field grass, not able to connect the throw in time. Good play there from Sam Baker, preventing it to get to the left fielder. But it'll be a single there for the Bears.
Now batting third baseman, number five, Matthew Redman.
So it'll be a two-out, one-man-on scenario here for the Bears. Pickoff move unsuccessful. With a left-handed pitcher, you're not going to see too much of a leadoff there from the first baseman. Goes to the plate this time. Shows bunt. Pulls it back for the ball. Shows bunt once again. Throws his second ball. Showing bunt here with two outs. Looks like we got some speed at the plate. Pickoff move once again. Much closer this time, requiring a dive back, but he is safe. Tebow with a more aggressive pickoff move there. Runner still second. Will steal successfully with no throwback from the catcher. So two pickoff moves, not enough to keep the base runner at bay as he does steal second. Next pitch, called strike. 2-1 count. To be a 2-1 count with two outs. Man on second. The second time in two consecutive innings the Bears have runners in scoring position. Another pickoff attempt will be unsuccessful. Good move there from Tebow. Sam Baker doing what he can to keep the runner also on second base as Tebow delivers another strike. One pitch away from ending this inning. Goes to the plate high. Called ball four. So Matthew Redman will get a walk here.
Off the bat, number three, Jacob Carvelis.
It With two outs here, they got two runners on base, first and second, as the nine-hole hitter, Jacob Carbeles, will step into the plate. Shows bunt, successfully bunts it up the third base line. The third baseman will get there and not throw it to first. So a good show of bunting there, perfectly up the third base line. No play for the Skyhawks. So it'll be bases loaded with two outs here for Tebow. We'll be back up to the top of the lineup here for Caleb Ramsey, the left fielder, as he steps in. Gets the call from the third base coach. Looking to extend the Bears' lead over the Skyhawks. Two outs here, one out, all we need. First pitch, call a strike. Good start there for Tebow. Second pitch swung on, into play. First baseman does make the play. Throws it over to the pitcher who gets the out. So with bases loaded, the Skyhawks are able to get that third out and prevent any more runs from scoring for the Bears. We're going to be taking a break here for the Skyhawk Sports Network. We return here at the bottom of the second inning. Silas Butler stepping in. Butler will take strike one. In this previous game, Butler was responsible for an RBI. Swung on, fouled away. In the Skyhawks' previous game against William Carey, they scored 11 runs. Butler was responsible for one of those RBIs. He'll take ball two. That ball is behind Silas Butler. Doesn't hit him, though. Third pitch will be a ball once again, so it'll be a 3-2 count. That ball will be put in play, rolled slowly to the third baseman, who throws it to the first. Safe is the runner. Silas Butler able to run that out. So a full swing there, but it's just a dribble up to the third baseman, who has to charge the ball. Really well collected. He throws it to the first, but just not in time. Silas Butler able to outrun that one.
Now batting number three, Mason Davis
stepping in. Nobody out here with one man on. Swung on, hit deep into center field. Popped up though. And the center fielder does make the catch, and Silas Butler will return to first base. Coming up to bat now, Chris Mansell, the catcher. Looking to advance the runner.
Now batting number 7, Chris Mansell.
Pickoff move unsuccessful. Lots of pickoff moves. First pitch to Davis is called a, or to Mansell is called a ball one. Lots of pickoff moves here from Truett-McConnell. The next pitch will be swung on and missed. Perhaps the Bears hit the scouting report for the Skyhawks and saw they had 5 stolen bases in their previous game, with only 1 caught stealing. 5 stolen bases, likely leading to the 11 runs the Skyhawks scored in the last game. Another pickoff move here will be unsuccessful. Runner attempts to steal second. Throw into the center field. Butler will get up and run to third. The throw in will not be in time as he will stand on third after the stolen base. That'll be an error on the catcher as he throws it in the center field away from the second baseman. Silas Butler will earn his stolen base. So all those pickoff move attempts here by the Skyhawks will be unsuccessful, or by the Bears will be unsuccessful. Just as the Skyhawks did in the last inning. Going to the plate there. Put in play to the shortstop who throws it to the first base. And it'll be a sacrifice out right there. Chris Mansell will get out on the ground out, but Silas Butler will score after the error from the catcher.
Now batting number 11, Sam Baker.
First pitch to Sam Baker is called a ball. So the Skyhawks do tie the ball game here in the bottom of the second inning. Second pitch is called a ball as well. Sam Baker here with 1 out, nobody on. Looking to get on base. He had a double in his last game. He swings at the ball here, puts it in play to the shortstop, who picks it up, throws it first, and gets the outs. So there were 2 outs on that play, so that'll be the final out for the Skyhawks, who do manage to tie the ball game at the bottom of the second inning. And we'll be back here on the Skyhawks Sports Network. At the top of the third inning, we have a new pitcher here for the Skyhawks, Justin England from Dallas, Georgia, stepping up to pitch here against the Bears. In his previous game, Justin England pitched one inning. As this ball is put into play to the shortstop, Sam Baker throws it to first and gets the outs. So be one out here early for Justin England.
Up to bat, second baseman, number 9, Tanner Griffin.
In his previous game, England pitched one inning with one strikeout and zero earned runs. Next pitch is called a strike. That pitch is called a strike as well. Pitching well here early is England. Gets the call, goes to the plate. Swung on, hit into the left field grass, comes in, and makes the catch. So England comes onto the mound here and gets two quick outs for the Skyhawks. Jordan Kinty looking for a two-out rally here with nobody on. Here's the first pitch he sees. It'll be a low ball one. Next pitch. Swung on, hit into play. Shortstop Sam Baker charges it but can't make the play. He'll retreat there and get the ball. And allows Jordan Kinty to get on first base with two outs. So a very tough play there for Sam Baker to make. Charges it well. Tries to get there before the next bounce. Hits his glove but cannot quite keep it in it. That'll go down for an error for Sam Baker, but a tough play to make for sure. First pitch there. Will be called a strike as he shows bunt. First baseman for the Bears up to bat. Pickoff move. Unsuccessful. Lots of pickoff moves here for both teams. Lots of aggressive runners. Next pitch goes to the plate. Ball just high. Batter steps back into the box. Looks over to the runner. Next pitch, call the ball. Well collected by the catcher. Very outside, but able to get there. Austin Tebow's start will end after two innings. One strikeout, one walk, one stolen base on him, and only one run given up. Runner still second, swung on and missed. The throw to the second baseman, unsuccessful, so he will have a stolen base there. Be the second stolen base for the Bears in the top of the third inning. This time the catcher does throw it to the shortstop, but not in time. It's a 2-1 count here for the Skyhawks. Next pitch, fouled away. Runners in scoring position once again for Truett-McConnell. All three innings they've had runners in scoring position. Only one run on the board as they left the bases loaded in the previous inning. England comes to the mound. It'd be a full count here for the Truett-McConnell Bears. Two outs, man on second. Swung on, fouled away. In play, the right fielder is not going to be able to make that play as the man in the bullpen almost catches that ball, but he lets it drop out of his glove. Got some bullpen action there out for the Bears. Appears that the Skyhawks do as well. It's a bullpen game for both teams. Next pitch, swung on and missed. It'll be strike three for the Skyhawks. Justin England able to pick up a strikeout there and leave a man on second. And we will see you at the bottom of the third inning. We got a new pitcher here for the Bears. It'll be Reese Blackiston. His first pitch will be a ball. Coming in here from the bottom of the third inning, as Philip Braswell completes two full innings, giving up one earned run with one strikeout. Both starters for both teams, as this is a ball two. Will complete two full innings and both give up one run. So tie ball game here in the bottom of the third inning, 1-1. Swung on and missed for a 2-1 count. Back to the top of the lineup here for the Skyhawks as Jaden Mazzaparo steps in. Looking to get on base to start something here for the Skyhawks. Next pitch is down low for ball three. Mazzaparo picked up two RBIs in his last game. As the next pitch is down the middle for strike two. To be a full count here with nobody out. Took all the way there, looking to get on base by the walk. Full count pitch. High ball four. Mazzaparo earns himself a walk. He's been on base twice now.
Off the bat, your right fielder, number one, Kenny Jackson.
So just like the bottom of the first inning, we got the bottom of the third inning here. With Mazzaparo on first, but Kenny Jackson stepping in. He'll take strike one. In the first rendition of this scenario, Kenny Jackson hit it to the shortstop for fielder's choice, able to run outs before getting to a double play. He'll swing here, hits it up to the third baseman, who throws it to the second baseman, and it will once again be a fielder's choice for Kenny Jackson. So a repeat of the first inning here. As Kenny Jackson replaces Mazzafaro on first once again.
Up the bat, number 8, Slay Me!
Slade Ming steps up to bat here with the man on first. Kenny Jackson will have a pickoff move. Just about to mention, he's leading pretty far off there over at the first base side. The left-handed pitcher, able to see over there pretty easily. Goes to the plate, swung on, put in play. The pitcher will ground his position, throw it over to first, and get Slade Ming out. So it'll be two outs here, but the runner does advance over to second base. So Zeb Baird will step into the box with runners in scoring position.
Your batter, number 33, Sam Baird!
Zeb Baird with a single in his last at-bat. Love another one here. Side will likely score the runner from second. Swings at the first pitch, fouled away. So Reese Blackiston, in his first inning of work, able to get two outs by the force out, but does have a man at second. Next pitch, call the ball. Next pitch, down low for a strike. Be a 1-2 count with two outs. Baird looking to put the ball in play here. Gets the call, does the pitcher. Finally steps on the rubber here. Goes to the plate, swung on, put in play. Shortstop gets in front of the ball, throws it over to first. And get Zeb Baird out. So that'll be three outs for the Skyhawks. And we will see you at the top of the fourth inning. Got a new pitcher here for the Skyhawks, Ben Beasley, the senior. Another left-handed pitcher here. Lots of left-handed pitchers in this game. Taking over for Justin England. His first pitch will be a ball. So Justin England's work will be completed after one inning. He struck out one opponent. No earned runs. So the game remains 1-1 between Truett-McConnell Bears and the Point University Skyhawks. Next pitch will be in there for a strike. 2-1 count here. That'll be a strike as well. Looks like an off-speed pitch there from the left-hander. Two-two count here. Can Beasley finish him off? Strikeout! There it is. He finishes him off with a swing and miss. Ben Beasley, first opponent he sees, strikes him out swinging.
Up the bat, center fielder number one, Ethan Roberts.
Ethan Roberts stepping in. He got on in his previous attempts. He managed to steal second. He'll take strike one here. Looking to keep speed off the bases. Another off-speed pitch. Absolutely wicked. As it's a swing and a miss there. Early 0-2 count. Ben Beasley looks to strike out his next opponent. Swung on. Just foul. That ball was inches away from being fair. It'll remain an 0-2 count. Swung on, hit, tipped by the catcher. The shortstop, Sam, takes it up, throws it over to first, gets him in time. So a really good job there from the Skyhawks as Ben Beasley manages to get his glove to the ball and virtually tip it over to Sam Baker at short. If Beasley's not able to tip that ball is certainly rolling up into center field for a base hit. Really good job there from Beasley, even though he doesn't get the out himself. He'll take the out regardless. First pitch there is a ball. Matthew Redman walked in his previous attempts. Takes ball two here. Looking to get on base once again. That's a strike right there. Beasley, two quick outs here for the Skyhawks. Throws his first couple of balls to a batter. Back on track with a strike there. Swung on, fouled back. Close to the press box, but we have a net. It'll be a 2-2 count with two outs here with nobody on. The bat's slowing down here for the Truett-McConnell Bears. Nobody on base in this inning. Next pitch, clips the batter. He'll get a free base off that hit by pitch. Just inside, clips his elbow, it looked like. Enough to get him on first base.
Up the bat, shortstop, number three, Jacob Carvelis.
So the nine-hole hitter will step in. Jacob Carvelis got a single in his last plate appearance via the bunt. He does get another call from the third base coach. Perhaps it's the same call as he got last time to bunt. Does not show bunt. Swings on it. Hits it through for the third baseman. Runner will round second. Slide into third. Doesn't slide in. Runs into the third baseman. Knocks him off and can't make the play. But the pitcher with a really good job backing him up. Able to make that play. Not sure if anything goes on there. The runner will advance from first to second as well. So it'll be runners at second and third. Doesn't appear to be any sort of wrong play there as he runs into the third baseman, preventing him from making the play. The ball wasn't thrown in time, but not sure you can just shove him over like that. So it'll be runners on second and third with two outs. The Bears looking to get on the board once again. First pitch will be called a ball to the top man back on the order, Caleb Ramsey. So Beasley with two heads-up plays here in this inning as he delivers a strike. Smart play there from the pitcher backing up his third baseman. Two runners here in scoring position, two outs. Got some movement in the bullpen for the Skyhawks. No movement in the bullpen currently for the Bears as the next pitch is called a ball. Truett-McConnell likely has their next pitcher in the dugout already with two outs here. Beasley trying to get out of this inning without giving up any runs. That'll be strike two via the foul off. 2-2 count with two outs once again. Can Beasley wiggle his way out of this one? Here's the pitch. Just barely called a ball. Batter took all the way there. Dangerously. With two men in running position, scoring position, not sure you want to be taking pitches with two strikes and two outs. It'll be a full count with two outs. The crowd is getting rowdy. Here's the pitch. Ball four. So the free base open at first base is not going to kill the Skyhawks. But they got to get it out right here. Nowhere to put this next batter.
Up the bat, designated hitter, number 20, Brody Ginter.
So Brody Ginter did ground out in his previous plate appearance. Skyhawks looking to do that same thing here. Bases loaded here again for the Bears. They had bases loaded in the top of the second inning, but were unsuccessful in getting anybody home. First pitch, swung on. Through the gap in between the shortstop and third baseman. The runner from second will run around the third baseman. Here's the play. Not caught by the catcher. He'll stop the ball, but two runners will score for the Bears. So first pitch swing in there from Brody Ginter. Able to ground it through the shortstop and the third baseman into left field. Collects it, throws it in, but not in time to get two runners in. Tanner Griffith will step up for the Bears with runners on first and second. Two outs still. Beasley looking to end the bleeding here. Shows bunt. Ball one. Bears are going to get a new call here from the third base coach. Beasley taking his time pitching out there now. Ball two. So Beasley strikes out his first batter. Gets the out on the second batter as well. And now has given up four straight base runners, including two earned runs. Goes to the plate. That'll be called strike. 2-1 count here for the Skyhawks. Runners will advance. It'll be called strike three, but the catcher will not throw over to third. So only one runner advances there. A dangerous play by the Skyhawks, not even throwing. So it'll be runners on first and third for the Bears. Possibly going to look for some sort of strategical play to get that runner from third over to home with two outs. It'll be a 2-2 count. The Bears are going to have their second stolen base. Goes to the plate. Swung on, fouled away. Behind the plate. Chris Mansell catching for the Skyhawks. Catches a lot of games for them, but Easton Harrison not catching today. Not a conference game here. Next pitch, swung on, fouled away once again. This time to the right side and onto the tennis courts. It'll remain a 2-2 count. No need to throw to the third baseman to try and catch that runner stealing, so I'll just let him go. Throw to the plate. Inside, well collected there from the catcher. Does not hit the batter. It'll be a full count. Beasley, once again in a full count. Can he put the Bears away? Here's the pitch. Swung on and missed. He gets the second strikeout of the inning and ends the bleeding for the Skyhawks. It'll be a 3-1 lead now for the Bears as they will attempt to get back into this game at the bottom of the fourth inning here on the Skyhawk Sports Network. Down 3-1 are the Skyhawks as Alex Marquand steps up to bat in the bottom of the fourth inning. Reese Blackiston still on the mound here for the Bears. His first pitch to Alex is a strike one. Marquand looking to get something going here. He did not go. Started his swing, but did not go all the way around for the 1-1 count. Marquand started his swing and jumped out of the way. Fouled away. Right at me. Got me on my toes. Two strikes, one ball. Blackenstein, the second pitcher here for the Bears to face his second inning of work. Swung on. Just foul the right side of the first base. On top of his double and his home run in his last game, Mark Hong with two RBIs as well. Swung on, put in play. Right fielder backing up. He will make that catch, and Mark Hong will be out. Be one out here for the Skyhawks.
Now batting number two, Silas Butler.
Silas Butler stepping in, one out. Got a single in his last plate appearance. Also managed to steal a base and score a run. First pitch, call the ball high above the plate. Next pitch, closer and will be called a strike. Not too far from the first pitch, but definitely closer, and that one will be a strike. Swung on that one. Fouled back. Seven hits here through four innings for the Bears and five hits for the Skyhawks. 3-1 lead for the Bears. Next pitch is high for ball two. No longer are the Skyhawks and the Bears in the same conference, but two former rivals looking to keep what they have against each other and earn that win. Swung on, hit in play, high, into the center field grass. Center fielder gets under the ball and makes the catch. So the first batter is an F9, second batter is an F8. Well, the Skyhawks get the trio and hit it to the left fielder this time.
Up the bat for the Skyhawks is number three, Mason Davis.
First pitch to Davis, swung on. Well, collected by the shortstop, throws it to first, and in time. Good play there from the shortstop as he's able to collect the ball all the way in the left field grass, throw it over to first base in time, and Davis will be out. And that'll be it for the Skyhawks as they go down without any danger to the Bears. And we'll be back here on the Skyhawks Sports Network.
17, Jordan Kinsey.
Got a new pitcher here for the Skyhawks, Rafael Perez, the junior from the Dominican Republic. His first pitch will hit the batter. And he is in pain. Takes two knees and will jog over to first base. His dugout will scream some stuff at him and appears to be okay. Took that one in the center of the back. Not a good start here for Perez. So Ben Beasley able to complete one inning of work, earns two strikeouts, but will also earn two earned runs. As Perez in the pitch, his next pitch is a strike one. The first baseman shows bunt there, looking to maybe advance that runner over to second from first. Next pitch will be a strike. Perez looking like he's throwing heat out there. That ball is getting to the catcher in a hurry. O-2 count here. Swung on, hit deep into left field. Left fielder able to track it well. Gets underneath it and makes the catch. Runner will remain at first. The ball comes in quickly. So Perez, great job there in the second at bat. Quickly gets ahead 0-2 and gets the fly out to the 7-man. Got a pinch hitter here for the Bears, number 13. Dylan Sargent.
Pinch hitting, number 13, Dylan Sargent.
Runner tries to steal second, but it will be a foul ball, I believe. Didn't quite catch it as I was looking at the runner. So the runner's at second base. Got to go back to first as he now jogs over. So not 100% sure exactly what happened there. Like I said, I was watching the runner. I'm not sure if that hit the batter and he went all the way around or if he foul tipped it. Either way, it's a strike. And the runner will be forced to stay at first. Swung on, hits to Sam Baker, who throws it over to the second baseman. Throws it over to first, and there's a double play for the Skyhawks. Going to be a quick inning of work there for Perez as he gets three outs for the Skyhawks. And we'll be back here on the Skyhawk Sports Network. Here we are in the bottom of the fifth inning for the Skyhawks. Up to bat, Chris Mansell.
Up to bat, your catcher number 7, Chris Mansell.
Reese Blackiston still pitching for the Bears. Now they got somebody in the bullpen. Nope. First pitch is hit through for a base hit. Mansell rounding first. Over to second. Left fielder stumbles trying to get the ball, but he will remain at second, sliding in safely. So an aggressive at-bat there for Mansell as he swings at the first pitch. Grounds it past the third baseman, who slides and can't make the play. Going to be an early runner in scoring position for the Skyhawks.
Up the bat for Skyhawks, number 11, Sam Baker. Pinch runner for the Skyhawks, number 4, Hunter Neumeyer.
Hunter Neumeyer will be the pinch runner for the Skyhawks, number 4. Sam Baker had a double in his last game, but he also had two RBIs, looking to add to that number here today. His first pitch shows bunt, bunts it down well to the third base line. Catcher collects it, throws it to first. Does not make the catch, does the first baseman. Runner advances home, slides, does a slide, safe. Hunter Neumeyer aggressive there, rounding third. And able to score. The tag was applied right as he touched the bag as he doesn't slide. He would easily slid in safely, but he runs and able to score for the Skyhawks. So it'll be 3-2. The Bears still lead over the Skyhawks. But a perfect bunt from Sam Baker.
Now batting for your Skyhawks, number 6, Jaden Mazzaparo.
So a recap of what just happened. Sam Baker bunts it down the left-hand line. Pitcher does a good job running over, collects it, throws it to the first baseman. Looks like it would have been in time, but the first baseman not quite able to make that catch as this ball is fouled away. And so with the first baseman dropping the ball, Hunter Neumeyer keeps his momentum going forward towards the home plate. First baseman collects the ball, throws it to home, not quite in time, just by a step. So it'll be no outs, one man on first, one strike here. At the top of the order, here's a pickoff move, unsuccessful. Sam Baker with a nice lead out there at first. Next pitch is a ball. Back to the top of the lineup for the Skyhawks. Jaden Mazzaparo steps up. He's been on base twice in this game with a single and a walk. So Reese Blackenston pitched well in his first two innings of work, but in his third has now given up an earned run. Two hits in this inning alone. Next pitch is just high, called ball two. Appears that the bullpen now finally fully warming up. So it looks like it's going to be Blackston's inning of work here, maybe. Quick pickoff move. Will not be caught by the first baseman. Sam Baker running to second. He can advance to third. That's the ball just now getting back into play. So maybe a poor decision there by Blackston as he tries to pick off Baker. Throws it wide to the first baseman as Baker's also standing in the way as he tries to return to first base. It'll get past him. Over to the warning track next to the dugout. Baker will round second and make it to third. I believe that's the second mistake that the pitchers have made so far for the Bears. Here's the next pitch. Swung on, fouled away. So with what appears to be three balls and two strikes here for Mazzaparo, he'll now have a runner at third with no outs. Skyhawks should be able to tie this ball game up here in this inning. Nobody out. Ooh, that ball was going to come in on Mazzaparo and hit him in the back. And he'll earn his third free base. He'll be on base three times in this game. Be the single, the walk, and the hit by pitch. Here's the Bears coach looking to bring in a new pitcher as Blackiston will be done for the day. Here comes the new pitcher. It'll be runners at first and third. for the Skyhawks with nobody out. The new pitcher is number 10. For the Bears. The new pitcher here for the Truett-McConnell Bears is Ryan Coffinauer, number 10. The freshman out of Woodstock, Georgia, coming in to pitch for the Bears. Not an easy situation that he's coming into with runners at first and third, looking to hold on to that lead, but with nobody out, that is a tough mission for him to do. There's an off-speed pitch warm-up. It'll be Kenny Jackson stepping up to face him first. The lefty-righty matchup, or the righty-lefty matchup, I should say. Right-handed pitcher, left-handed batter. Kenny Jackson responsible for two fielder's choices in this game. Wouldn't mind seeing the fielder's choice here as long as the runner scores from third. Mazzafaro setting up Kenny Jackson well in this game, but Kenny not quite delivering on his end. But with nobody out here, we're looking to get some runs on the board or the Skyhawks.
The bat for Skyhawks is number one, Kenny Jackson.
So Reese Blackenston makes it through two full innings of work. In those two innings of work that he completed, he did not give up any runs. But in this third inning of work, he does not get any outs. Does have an earned run and is responsible for the runners on first and third. As Kenny Jackson takes ball one. Bears tried to stretch out Blackenston, making him do some extra work, but unsuccessful. Second pitch is just barely called a strike. Reaches to the top of the zone. You can hear the cries and the moans from the Skyhawks. Next pitch is high. Runners on first and third. Maybe he could get some action over there at first and get that runner in from third. Next pitch is a ball. Ball three. See what Kenny decides to do here. Take all the way or maybe get that bat swinging. Aggressive lead over there at first. Mazzafaro stays. Next pitch is ball four. So Ryan Coffinauer comes in. Walks his first batter, only earning one strike. And it'll be up to Slade Mink to bring them home.
Up the bat, number 8, Slade Mink!
Looks like Slade Mink has struck out in his first plate appearance, and his second also earned himself a fielder's choice. Nowhere to put him here, as there's nobody out with three men on base. He hits the ball hard! Out to left field. Left fielder backing up onto the warning track. Able to get under the ball. Makes the catch. The runners will advance from second and third. And will score the runner. So right there, the Skyhawks tie the game. A loud crack of the bat from Slade Mink as he flies out to the left fielder. And the cheers from the Skyhawks.
Now batting number 33, Sam Bear.
So after that slacker price fly and two runners advancing, it'll be first and third for the Skyhawks, now with one out. Seb Baird could easily get the Skyhawks to lead here with a single. That first pitch will be fouled up. Out of play just barely for the first baseman as he almost is able to make that play. But over the fence does the ball go. Just by a few feet. It'll remain one strike. Runners on first and third. Ryan Coffinauer does earn himself an out. Runner's still second. A hit and run play. That runner's going to have to run back to first. He'll throw it to first, and it will not be in time, but he's able to step on the base in time and get the third out. So Kenny Jackson tries to steal second there. The ball's hit straight to the right fielder on a line drive, and he's able to throw it to first. Not a good throw, but he does give the first baseman enough time to step on the bag and earn the third out. So that'll be it for the Skyhawks as they tie the game in the bottom of the fifth. And then we will see you at the top of the sixth on the Skyhawk Sports Network. Coming into pitch for the top of the sixth inning is a new pitcher for the Skyhawks, Cole Johnson, the sophomore from New Site, Alabama. His first pitch is a strike one. Cole Johnson pitching well so far this season. Don't have the exact stats in front of me, but as a fan, I've seen him, and he is not let up and earned run from what I've seen. Second pitch is called a strike once again there. Early 0-2 count for Cole. Different throwing arm. He's a sidearm pitcher. His next pitch is fouled away into the net of the dugout for the Skyhawks. So the Skyhawks threatened to take the lead there in that bottom of the fifth inning, but with a bit of a mental error from the Skyhawks, they are going to get a double play. Looks like the home base umpires had enough of the Bears extending that dugout and tells them to stay in the dugout. Here's the pitch from Cole Johnson. Ooh, well outside is from Cole. Always wonder if what the umpire had to say threw him off his balance. It's going to be a 1-2 count here. Cole's still ahead in this at-bat. And just barely outside is that next pitch for a 2-2 count. Cole looking to put this batter away. Next pitch swung on, hits the second baseman. Gets in front of it, throws it over to first, and we'll get the out. So Cole Johnson earns himself his first out. So Ethan Roberts grounds out to the second baseman. Matthew Redman coming in, third baseman here. Cole Johnson off to a good start, able to put out his first batter. his first pitch to this next batter. It's going to be called a ball. Chris Mansfield behind the plate. Hasn't made any errors yet as a catcher. Always good to see. Shows bunt. They call it a strike. Looked outside for me, but we'll take the strike to the Skyhawks. That next pitch will be a little bit further outside, so it'll be called a ball. The catcher, Chris Mansell, switching up his catching stance with Cole on the mound. This next pitch is hit to the shortstop, Sam Baker. Collects the ball, throws it over to first, and Zeb Baird makes that catch. This will be two ground outs here for Cole. And nobody on base yet. So the 9-hole hitter, Jacob Carbellis, will step into the bat. Got on his first time, did not get on his second time. We'll be facing Cole Johnson here. Shows bunt, pulls away, be ball one. Cole Johnson's next pitch is going to be outside. Lots of outside pitches here from Johnson. Not willing to come inside. Next pitch, swung on, fouled away. Be a 2-1 count. Two outs, nobody on. Skyhawks have tied this game up. Strike two. Swung on and missed. The 9-hole hitter, Jacob Carbellis, looking to swing the bat on that attempt. Appears the Skyhawks do have somebody in the bullpen over there. With the Bears, nobody in the bullpen. Here's the next pitch. Ball three. It'll be a full count here. Two outs. Quite the battle here from Carbellis and Johnson. His pitch will, I believe that might have hit the batter, but it'll be ball four regardless. Cole Johnson taps his chest. Knowing he made a bit of a mistake there, but only one man on with two outs. Should be able to get out of this inning with no harm. Back to the top of the order is the Bears. Caleb Ramsey steps in. Carvelis with quite the lead out there. As this first pitch comes inside, let me call the ball one. Carvelis is definitely looking to steal maybe against this right-handed pitcher. Next pitch, be a high ball two. Little fake toss over there to the first baseman from Johnson. He'll come to the plate for ball three. Well framed by the catcher, but too far outside to be called a strike. Three consecutive balls from Johnson. Threatening to walk his second batter in a row here. He does just that. This will be ball four. So runners now on for first and second from Johnson with two outs. Brody Ginter steps in, looking to put the Truett-McConnell Bears back in the lead. Here's the pitch, swung on, put in play. Third baseman will collect it easily, step on the third base bag, and that'll be it for the Bears. So the Skyhawks able to prevent any more runs from scoring, and it'll remain a tie ball game. Alex Marquand stepping up the bat here. He'll get his second chance to hit the bat in consecutive innings as he never got to complete his first at-bat. Actually, he never got to swing the bat at all after that double play. First pitch is called a ball as Ron Koffenauer, the freshman, still on the mound for the Bears. It'll be called strike as his second pitch. The righty-lefty matchup here. Marquand yet to really make anything happen as he puts the ball just foul. Hoping to get on base. It's the bottom of the sixth inning here. Tie ball game 3-3. Now the Skyhawks will be told to stay in the dugout from the home plate umpire. Not sure really who he's talking to. As the foul ball, one of the Skyhawks had to go retrieve it. I believe he might have been talking to him. Next pitch is outside. Marquand quite animated in the batter's box. He tries to sell those balls. That next pitch is swung on and missed. It'll get by the catcher, but it'll be a 2-2 count. Nobody on base, nobody advances. Marquand steps back into the box. Seven hits each for both teams. He hits the ball here. Puts it into the center field grass. Center fielder will make the catch, and Marquand will return the dugout 0-3 in this game. The six-hole hitter steps up to the bat, Silas Butler. He has always a bunting here to the left-hand line. It'll be just foul. So Silas Butler has flown out to the center fielder. And he has hit a single and scored. He has stolen the base. 1-for-2 on the day. Steps in here with a one strike count. Hits it hard. Real hard. Left fielder retreating back, and that ball will be out of here. It's a fair ball home run.
Home run!
Silas Butler hits that ball hard straight out to the left field line. Fair ball and will be gone. Silas Butler able to put the Skyhawks in the lead 4-3 over the Bears.
Now batting number 3, Mason Davis.
Silas Butler, really good job there. Aggressive with the bat in his hands. Sends that ball over the left fielder's head and out for the home run. It'll be Mason Davis' turn to hit the bat. Now with a Skyhawk lead for the first time in this game. 4-3. It'll be a 2-1 count here. As he hits that one hard over the left fielder's head. He's backing up. And it will be caught. No, it will not. It'll be a home run for the Skyhawks.
Home run.
Back-to-back home runs.
Mason Davis
able to launch that ball right over the left fielder's head. The left fielder does a great job tracking that ball all the way to the fence. He jumps up, fools me. I thought he was going to make that catch, but it's over his head for a home run.
Now batting for the Skyhawks is number 7, Chris Mantle.
Back-to-back home runs right there. Silas Butler, Mason Davis, both pulls it over the left fielder's head. And looks like the freshman, Ryan Koffenauer, shooken up a little bit as he throws the ball well outside the catcher's ability to catch it. And it'll roll all the way to the backstop. Nobody on, though. Chris Mansell off the bat. Can he get the three-peat? Pull another home run off. Some three right-handed hitters in a row. Can we get another pull home run here? Next pitch, swung on, fouled away. Be a 2-1 count here for Mansell. Ryan Koffenauer able to shut the Skyhawks down in his previous inning of work, but now has given up two consecutive home runs after getting the first out here. Mansell roasts that left field. That will be down for a base hit. He will stop at first. So another pull hit there from the right-handed hitter. And it'll be Sam Baker starting to hit the ball. Mansell is going to get pinch ran for.
Number 11, Sam Baker.
It'll be Hunter Neumeier pinch running for Mansell. Neumeier already with a run scored here in this game. Looking to be aggressive on the bases with only one out. Gets his lead off there. It's a decent lead. Definitely threatened to steal the base for his pitch. Let's call the strike on Sam Baker. So three consecutive hits here for the Skyhawks. The Bears do have one man warming up in the bullpen. As a big secondary lead there from Hunter Neumeier. Skyhawks' typical pinch runner whenever a catcher gets on base. It's still the freshman's inning of work here. Ryan Koffenauer throws it over to first base. Unsuccessful as the pickoff attempt. Even though Hunter Neumeier was leading off quite a lot. So this is definitely the Skyhawks' best inning. As this ball is going to get put in play to the shortstop. Throws it over to second in time to get Hunter Neumeier. But Sam Baker will get his self on first base.
Up the bat for your scars, it's number 6, Jaden Mazzafaro.
So with two outs here, we're back to the top of the lineup for the Skyhawks for Jaden Mazzafaro. He's been our most consistent player getting on base as he is 3-for-3 getting on base this game. Getting on base any way he can as his first pitch will be called a strike. He hasn't earned himself a single, a walk, and a hit by pitch in this game. Sam Baker will remain on first after the fielder's choice. Second pitch, framed well by the catcher. It'll be a strike two. Ryan Koffenauer, the pitcher, looking to end this inning and get the Bear bats up. Runner advances. Poor throw there from the catcher. Will be caught by the shortstop, but Sam Baker will earn himself a stolen base. Second stolen base there for the Skyhawks. That'll actually be Sam Baker's second stolen base by himself. That's a third stolen base there for the Skyhawks. Silas Butler gets one. Sam Baker now has two. Remember, the catcher missed the shortstop in his first attempt to throw out Sam Baker and allowed Sam Baker to get to third. Mazzaparo will take a high ball, too. Be a 2-2 count with two outs here. Skyhawks looking to extend their lead from 5. Now with 11 hits. Next pitch, swung on, hit deep into center field. The center fielder is looking to get underneath it, and he does for the third out. So Ryan Koffenauer gives up two consecutive home runs, as well as another hit after that, but able to get done and finish the inning himself. It'll be a 5-3 lead for the Skyhawks as we enter the seventh inning on the Skyhawks Sports Network. Entering the top of the seventh inning, we have a new pitcher here for the Skyhawks. It is number 37, Carson Curry. For his first inning work. The right-handed pitcher delivers and earns himself strike one. So Cole Johnson finishes his day with two walks, but zero earned runs. One full inning work. Carson Curry will have a hit here. Shortstop makes the play, throws it over to first, and gets the out. So ground out there from number 9, Tanner Griffith. Good play there from Sam Baker as he has to travel a long distance, almost all the way over to the second base, but he's able to get there and throw it in time. So Carson Curry earns himself his first out. Jordan Kinsey steps up to bat here. His first pitch will be roped past the third baseman into the left field. Left fielder able to collect the ball, throw it into second, and prevents the runner from advancing from first. Throws it back over to first, but will not be in time. So, an extended round there from the runner, but not enough to catch him. As he doesn't commit fully to go to second, and is able to get back on first in time. So it'll be one out, one man on first. Carson Curry's next pitch will be in the dirt. Ball one. His next pitch is going to be in there for a strike. Skyhawks have taken the lead over their former conference opponents, the Truett-McConnell Bears, 5-3. Pickoff attempt there will be unsuccessful. Your Skyhawks will be traveling to Loyola for their next conference games. Next pitch is strike two. All the way to Louisiana to play Loyola. 1-2 in the conference, looking to get over 500. Runner advances from first will be safe. Good catch there from Sam Baker as the throw from Mansell. Very far onto the second base side, or the first base side, I should say, of second base. Jordan Kinty will earn himself his second stolen base of the game. Will be runners in scoring position now as that runner is at second with only one out. Curry could use a strikeout here with two strikes. That'll be a hit towards the shortstop. Collects it, knocks it down, throws it to first in time, and gets the out. Sam Baker not quite able to collect it perfectly, but he knocks it down very well. Collects it, throws it to first in time. Just barely, but gets it there. With the ball in front of the runner, he will not be able to advance. So it'll be a runner at second, when now with two outs for Carson Curry. Caleb Dare, the catcher for the Bears, up to bat. Actually, it looks like a pinch runner. And that'll be out number three for the Skyhawks. And we'll be entering the bottom of the seventh after this break on the Skyhawks Sports Network. leading off the bottom of the seventh inning is Kenny Jackson. Got a new pitcher here for the Bears. After this pitch, be ball one. Be Davis Richardson. Catching the last few innings is number 13 for the Bears. Dylan Sargent, as he came on to pinch hit earlier in the game. Be strike one there for the Kenny Jackson's 1-1 count. Next pitch swung on. Hit to the second baseman who can't make the play. Kenny Jackson will run it out. Be likely an error there for the second baseman as he not able to make that ground ball.
Now batting number 8, Slade Mink.
Slade Mink stepping into bat. Kenny Jackson on first here for Slade Mink as he takes strike one. So an easy ground out to the second baseman. He does have a little bit of ground to cover, but certainly should have made that play as it's a slow roller. Knocks it down and keeps it in front of him, but not able to collect it. Pickoff attempt here. Trying to keep Kenny Jackson on. Slade Mink up the bat. He had a sacrifice fly in his last at-bat. Getting the bat on the ball here in his last two plays. So he gets this one into the gap of right field, but the right fielder should be able to get there in time. Kenny Jackson will run back to first this time and will not get caught stealing and thrown out.
Now batting for Wisconsin, number 33, Sam Bear.
Kenny Jackson with a better read that time on whether the right fielder would catch it or not. But almost gets caught again. Kenny Jackson with a big lead off there up first with the left-handed pitcher out. First pitch swung on by Baird. Baird with a single in this game as well as, I believe, in a couple outs. Looking to get back in that hitter's column. Second pitch swung on. Hit deep in the right field. And the right fielder will not make that catch. Kenny Jackson's going to round second. Zeb Bear's going to round first. Go to second. Kenny Jackson's going to stay at third with one out. It'll be runners at second and third. So the right fielder has to come in and dive on that play. Will likely not be an error. But it looks like he froze up on that play. Not sure whether he should charge it. Now, or if we had enough time to stand there.
Number 13, Alex Marquand.
So Zeb Baird able to avoid his third F9 in this ballgame. And Marquand will step up to bat. Now with two runners in scoring position, nobody at first. So we should be able to avoid the double play here. Marquand will hopefully get in the batter's box and earn ourselves a bigger lead. Steps in. Swung on, knocks it. It will not leave the infield, so Marquand will be out, but no advancement from the runners, and no runs will be scored. So Marquand now 0-for-4 in this game.
Up to bat for Wisconsin, number two, Silas Butler.
Marquand, one of the hottest hitters for the Skyhawks, definitely cooled off in this game. It'll be Silas Butler's turn to hit. His last at-bat was a home run over the left field wall. Silas Butler takes his first pitch. It'll be called a strike. So with two outs, we still have two runners in scoring position. Davis Richardson will deliver ball one. Trying to get himself out of this inning without any earned runs. Next pitch inside. Skyhawks looking to earn a couple more runs in this inning to make it two runs in three consecutive innings. We ball three here. 3-1 count for Silas Butler. They got a base to put him on. With two outs, wouldn't it be a horrible decision to walk him here at the 3-1 count? Home run in his previous at-bat, but not liking to move on to the next batter as he hit a home run in his last at-bat as well. Be a swung on and missed. Silas Butler will be in a full count situation here. Teams will often look to walk a batter that hit a home run in his previous at-bat, but this will be a ball four. Silas Butler will earn himself a walk and put the second home run hitter, Mason Davis, up to bat.
Now batting your second baseman, number 3, Mason Davis.
So the junior, Davis Richardson, loads the bases with two outs. Gets the call from the coach. Mason Davis steps up to bat. Looking to get himself another home run. This will be a grand slam. First pitch is called a strike. Well outside, but gets enough of the plate to be a called a strike. Next pitch is called a ball high. Got Kenny Jackson at third, Slane Meek at second. Silas Butler at first. 2-1 count here for the second baseman, Mason Davis. This pitch just barely called a ball. Off-speed pitch looked like it might have hooked into the base, but not enough. Did not catch enough of the zone to be called a strike. Be 3-1 count here. Nowhere to put the batter. So an earned walk will score a run here for the Skyhawks. See what he does. Here's the pitch. Swung on. Fouled back. It'll be a full count in consecutive at-bats. But like I said, nowhere to put the batter. So a walk will benefit the Skyhawks. Strikeout in the inning for the strikeout for the Skyhawks with all the bases loaded. Next pitch is very high. It'll earn a walk, and it'll be a 6-3 ball game. Skyhawks lead.
Now batting number 7, Chris Menzel.
Got a left-hander warming up in the bullpen over there for the Bears. It's a right-hander. Be Chris Mansell. He had a hit in his last at-bat. He's going to get a hit right here with bases loaded still with two outs. It'll be two consecutive balls here to Chris Mansell. Catcher looking on base, looking to get on base here with a shortstop on deck. That'll be ball three. So three consecutive balls to start off this at bat after two consecutive walks. Nowhere to put the batter. Richardson looking to get back on track with a strike here. That'll be ball four once again. So two consecutive walks here. We'll walk in another runner. It'll be a 7-3 ball game. Skyhawks take the lead as now the Truett-McConnell Bears coach will walk out. And hasn't now he points over the bullpen, so it'll be a new pitcher here for the Bears. And that'll be it for Davis Richardson. With Sam Baker stepping into the box, the new pitcher for the Bears is Ben Glines, sophomore from Dalton, Georgia. Left-handed pitcher confirmed. His first pitch is a bunt here for Sam Baker and not going to be caught by the catcher. It'll be a foul ball. The catcher is not able to end this inning for the Truett-McConnell Bears. Sam Baker showing the bunt here with bases loaded and two outs. The fans are asking him to swing the bat, and I must agree. So the catcher narrowly misses making that catch. Sergeant has to turn fully around in order to get there as Baker fouls this next pitch off. But with the sun directly in his eyes when he turns that way, might have lost it. O-2 count here for Baker. Swings at this one. It'll be fouled away once again. Skyhawks have already scored two runs in this inning. Baker will earn himself a ball. Well framed from the catcher, Sergeant. Just barely outside. So Skyhawks have scored two runs in three consecutive innings. And have taken a 7-3 lead over Truett-McConnell. Sam Baker fouls another one off. Remain a 1-2 count. Truett-McConnell had the lead 1-0 as well as 3-1. But now trails 7-3 here in the bottom of the seventh. Sam Baker hits the ball hard. It'll be out of play left. Foul ball. Baker making a lot of contact here with two strikes. Staying alive in this at-bat. Baker with two stolen bases. A threat on base for sure. Makes contact there. And third baseman catches the ball and steps on the bag. And that'll be it for the Skyhawks, who do score two runs in this inning and now have a 7-3 lead. And we'll be back here in the top of the eighth inning on the Skyhawk Sports Network.
Number one, Ethan Roberts.
Got a new pitcher here with the Skyhawks at the top of the eighth inning, and it's Joshua Castillo. Number 19, the right-handed pitcher from California. He earns himself strike one here in this at-bat. So your Skyhawks will be facing Loyola on Friday. They have a doubleheader at 2 and 4:30, so they continue conference play. They have their third game against them on Saturday at 2 o'clock. Montreat travels to, the Truett-McConnell Bears travel to Montreat on Friday at 2, and a doubleheader at Saturday at 1 and 4. Here's the pitch. Ball one, just barely outside, almost got the strikeout. So Carson Curry will be done pitching today. He managed to get through an inning of work without any earned runs. Ball two. Skyhawks have put a lot of good work here at the bat today. 13 hits, 7 earned runs. That'll be inside, just ball. Full count here. Be swung on, put it in play. Third baseman makes a play, throws over to first, and well picked up by Baird. Slade Mink, not with a very clean throw over there at third, but picked off the ground for Baird. We'll complete the first out of the inning. Castillo's next pitch will be ball one. So 7 pitchers in 8 innings for the Skyhawks. As Castillo delivers ball two. Only the starter, Austin Thibault, pitches more than one inning. Next pitch is for a strike at the ball. Be 2 balls, 1 count. 2 balls, 1 strike. That ball is put in play. It'll get by the third baseman as he can't quite make the play. Be a single there. So Mink makes the first play of the inning, but can't quite make that second one. Ball comes in on him hard. Able to block it with his body, but it'll get past him. Roll a little bit far away from him and earn the Bears a single. Shows bunt, pulls away, that'll be strike one. Looks like once again another off-speed pitch there from the Skyhawks pitcher. Castillo will be ahead of this count, 0-1. Second pitch, throws a fastball, that one. We get further ahead of this count, 0-2. Bit of a lead over there at first, but not too much. Truett-McConnell only has 5 outs left in this game. Did he go all the way around? Yes, he did. Castillo will get himself a strikeout. It'll be 2 outs in the top of the 8th inning. Back to the top of the order for the Bears is Caleb Ramsey. Won't swing at the first pitch, but it'll still be called a strike. Not a whole lot of movement over there at first base. Not a big lead either. Second pitch, swung on. Be strike two. Getting ahead of this count as well. Looks like we got some movement over there in the Bears bullpen. We got a sidearm thrower, right-handed pitcher. Castillo checks first, gets the signal, comes to the plate, and earns himself strikeout number two. That'll be it for the Bears in the top of the eighth inning. Castillo will go down with two strikeouts in his first inning of work. And we'll be back at the bottom of the eighth inning on the Skyhawk Sports Network. Entering the bottom of the eighth inning, we're back to the top of the lineup for the Skyhawks as Jaden Mazzafaro will step in. Ben Klein still pitching for the Bears. Ball one. Got him. Got some movement over there in the Bears bullpen, but still going out there with thin lines as Mazzafaro fouls off that next pitch. Next pitch is going to be in there for strike two. Good inning of work there from Josh Castillo for the Skyhawks. He strikes out two consecutive batters. Glines looking for his first strikeout in this inning. It'll hit the batter. Mazzafaro tries to avoid that pitch and manages to get himself hit by that pitch. No argument from the Bears as they might have an argument that he put his hands in the way of that pitch, but mostly was trying to avoid it. So Mazzafaro will earn his second hit by pitch in this game. And has gotten on base at least four times in this game, which is what you want out of your leadoff hitter. Setting up those next batters. Kenny Jackson's going to step in here. No lead from Mazzafaro. Takes ball one. 7-3 ball game. Your Skyhawks lead it. Looking to add on here in the bottom of the eighth. That'll be a strike. Kenny Jackson watches that off-speed pitch creep in there. Next pitch is down low. Ball two. Here's the pitch. It'll be outside ball three. So with one man on base already, the Skyhawks looking to get a walk here. Put a second man on with nobody out. Here's the pitch. Swung on. Put it in play. First baseman will throw it to second, who throws it back to first, but will not be in time for Kenny Jackson. So it'll be Kenny Jackson's third fielder's choice of this ball game.
Up the bat for your Skyhawks is number 8, Slay Fake.
is Jaden Mazzaparo. Getting on base plenty of times, but not able to base run. As he continues to get out, via the fielder's choice. First pitch by Mink will be swung on and hit, but foul. Bit of a lead over there at first by Jackson as Mink takes ball one. That ball's going to be a hit, but it'll be foul. Well outside the ballpark. So Mink will be in a 1-2 count here with one out. Kenny Jackson remains at first base. Glime is still the pitcher for Truett-McConnell. Jackson moving around over there at first. Lines goes to the plate. Swung on. It'll be foul ball once again. Slug Mink looking to get on base here. Two stolen bases in his last game. Jackson with a lot of movement at first. This ball will get put in play to the shortstop. Shortstop bobbles. And safe will be Kenny Jackson at second base. So, bit of an unnecessary bit of movement over there at the shortstop position.
Now batting for his guys is number 33, Sam
Bear. So, the shortstop, Jacob Carvelis, with a really good backhand play to retrieve the ball. Instead of grabbing it out of his glove with his left hand, or his right hand, I should say, he tries to flick it up in the air and catch it with his hand to throw it over there to the second baseman, but he bobbles it. So unable to get not only one out, but it also prevents a double play from happening. Has a real chance to get a double play, but that'll definitely go down as an error for the Truett-McConnell Bears. Up to bat now is Zeb Barrett. As they try to catch the runner stealing on the pickoff move, but Kenny Jackson will be well ahead of that pickoff move. So the pickoff move will go to second, but by the time he gets to second, Jackson's just a step away from third base. So with one out, there's not going to be batters on, runners on first and third. Jackson on third, Mink on first. Barrett hits the ball, puts it in play. Foul, just barely fouled. Thought it might have grazed the third base, but umpire with a clear view gets the call of white. So Baird will remain in the box for the 1-1 count. Swung on, hit high into deep left field. Onto the warning track goes the left fielder. He does make that catch. And Kenny Jackson will score his second run of the ball game. As Zeb Barrett earns himself a sacrifice fly and puts the Skyhawks up 8-3.
Now batting for the Skyhawks is number 13, Alex Marquand.
After Bears' sacrifice fly, it'll be Slug Mink still at first base with two outs. Marquand stepping off the bat. 0-4 in the ballgame. Hard to believe that he'll be completely silent at the plate. He will watch that pitch go by him for strike one. Doesn't look like he wanted to compete for that one. Glynn's still out there pitching. Left-handed throws ball one. Crowd silenced. Here's the pitch. Ball two. Silas Butler on deck. We're going to get his potential final swing at the bat. with the Skyhawks leading, we might not see a bottom of the ninth inning. That ball will come inside. Marquand able to dodge it. Two outs. 3-1 count. That'd be ball four. So Marquand will manage to get on base here in this game via the walk, as he previously not on base. Looks like we got a new pitcher coming in for the Bears, trying to keep themselves in this ball game. Down 8-3. Only three outs left for the Bears to get some runs in. Going to be a new pitcher. We'll be back here on the Skyhawk Sports Network. The new pitcher stepping in for the Truett-McConnell Bears is Noah Smallwood, the freshman from Oxford, Georgia. He'll be thrown into a rough situation. He does have two outs, but there are runners at first and second. With Silas Butler stepping in. The sidearm pitcher will deliver strike one. Second sidearm pitcher we've seen, joining in with Cole Johnson of the Skyhawks. That ball will be swung on and missed for strike two. Smallwood looking to strike out Butler here. End the inning for the Skyhawks, who've already put up one run here. The ball is roped and just foul. Just foul. A few inches to the right, it would have been a fair ball hit off the third base. But it'll remain foul. Two strikes, two outs. 15 total hits for the Skyhawks here in today's game. Next pitch is going to be strike three. Outside pitch called strike three, and Silas Butler will strike out. And that'll end the inning for the Skyhawks, who now lead the game 8-3. new pitcher here for the Skyhawks, looking to close this game out. Not a closing situation, or a save situation, I should say, but Cooper Hack, number 16. A junior from Casper, Wyoming, looking to put this game away and earn the Skyhawks the win over Truett-McConnell. Second pitch is going to be called ball two. Your time is 5:38 here in Georgia. Sky slowly getting darker as the sun goes down, casting a bit of a shadow onto the field, but nothing that should affect the game. Next pitch is called a strike. Different aesthetic here in the ninth inning. If the Skyhawks can earn three outs without giving up any runs, or even at that, giving up four runs, the game will be over. Skyhawks currently lead 8-3. After four innings consecutively scoring runs for the Skyhawks. That ball is hit hard into left field. It will leave the ballpark. There's a home run for the Truett-McConnell Bears. As Brody able to get himself a home run there. The DH, Brody Ginter. That'll be the third home run this game. That has reached over the left field wall. Just a simple hit, able to reach that left field side of the ballpark and make it out of the... No runners on base there. It'll only be worth one run. Skyhawks still remain ahead of the Truett-McConnell Bears, 8-4. Truett-McConnell not willing to go down easily. Trying to put up a fight. That'll be strike one there. Way to get back on track there from Cooper Hack as he gives up his first home run. Next pitch. Batter wanted to go for it, but stays back. Manages to get the ball. That pitch comes in on the head. Manages to dodge it. Tanner Griffith looking to get on base here to keep the fight alive for Truett-McConnell. That ball is hit hard. That'll reach the outfield, but left fielder should be able to get under it as he does and makes the out. Tanner Griffith flies out to the left fielder. It'll be the first out for the Skyhawks.
Up the bat, number 17, George Kenton.
Cooper Hack gets his first out there. The Skyhawks with 15 total hits and 8 runs. Looking to transfer those live bats to Loyola on Friday. That pitch will hit the batter. Just barely skims him. And Cooper Hack will give up another base runner here. Still had 4 runs, so not too threatening from the Truett-McConnell. For Hackling to get back on track. Nobody in the bullpen for the Skyhawks, so it's going to be his game. Got some movement in the bullpen for the Bears should they manage to make a comeback here. That's a called strike. Should be a 1-1 count here for the 5-hole hitter. Checks the runner, throws his, just barely called the ball. That off-speed pitch nearly hitting the batter every time, but able to curve back in. It's a 1-2 count. That ball's hit. Third baseman able to collect it. Gets it up, throws it to the first base. Over Zeb Bear's head. Zeb Bear's going to have to go and retrieve that ball. Runners will advance to second and third. So good play there from Mink to be able to collect that ball, but he does throw it over to Baird. And Mink throws a little too high for Baird as he jumps and just barely misses catching that ball. So runners will remain safe on second and third here. Now the Bears are really looking to come alive here. Might be worth Skyhawks investing into somebody else in the bullpen. Bullpen remains activeless. Not sure that's a word. Be runners on second and third with one out. First pitch is called a strike. Barry looks a little shaken up over there at first. Maybe he hit his elbow. Seems to be okay. I think when he jumps, that ball is fouled away. I think when he jumped and tried to catch that ball, he slammed his elbow down on the runner. Certainly pacing around over there at first, but seems to be okay. Next pitch is swung on, strike three. That'll be the second out of the ball game. Top of the ninth inning there for Cooper Hack. Earns himself his first strikeout. Looking to get out of this inning with only one earned run here after that home run. So Ethan Roberts, potentially the final batter here in this ball game. Can Cooper Hack put him away and give the Skyhawks the win? First pitch, in there for strike one. Runners at second and third, nowhere to go. Don't need to be too active as they're not the winning runs or the tying runs. Second pitch, in the dirt. Not sure you would see those runners advance if it were in the dirt, just because, like I said, they're not the tying run or the winning run. It's not worth risking the out and losing the game for them. Next pitch is in the dirt, and like I said, nobody will advance as those runs currently aren't worth anything. Collected well there from catcher number 7. Chris Mansell definitely catching a good game. Giving up 3 stolen bases, but no wild pitches, no pass balls. Exactly what you want to see out of a catcher. That ball's going to be fouled away. Good catch there from Mink as he catches that foul ball. Be a 2-2 count. 2 strikes, 2 balls, 2 outs here at the top of the ninth inning. 1 strike away from ending this game. Cooper Hack, maybe not the inning he was looking for, but if he can earn the Skyhawks to win, he'll take it. Here's the pitch. Swung on, barely fouled away. Battle here from pitcher and batter. Both teams cheering their team on. Swung on, hit deep into center field. Center field doesn't have to move very much, and that is the ball game. Skyhawks will catch that ball and end the game 8-4. The Skyhawks and Point University will take the win over Truett-McConnell Bears 8-4. The Skyhawks will continue their action against Loyola on Friday and Saturday, and Truett-McConnell will be traveling over to Montreat Friday and Saturday as well. And thanks for watching. See you next time on the Skyhawk Sports Network.